Well, you're not a great performance today. It must have been a tough one out there.
Yeah, very difficult afternoon for us. Don't think we helped ourselves in the slightest. For instance, when you go to a football match, and before quality, you're wanting the hard work rate, the desire, the determination to go and compete, and we just didn't do that today all over the park, and obviously we've let the fans down, let ourselves down. We just need to kind of regroup and not put in a performance like that again, because it's not acceptable for ourselves personally.
We have tried to keep things tight in previous games, even if things haven't necessarily been going our way, and tight with the marking and stuff. As you say, it didn't really seem to be the case today. What went wrong?
I just think we didn't compete. To a man, you've got a task to go out and compete against the man you're up against, and I think we were standing off them, allowing them too much respect and space in the ball. When you look at both team sheets, there's not World Cup players in their team. They're not players that are miles ahead of us. We know we can compete if before the game kicks a ball, and I just think we're just miles off it today, and that comes with the players within, if nothing else. It's personal pride, determination to go out and compete and do your job, and to a man today, we felt as if we let ourselves down.
And was it perhaps that standing off that you mentioned there that potentially handed the initiative to United and got them on the front foot?
Yeah, I think so. I think they got confidence from that. When the first goal went in, I think a few of the boys' heads went down, and when times are tough just now, you can't allow that to affect you. You have to just kind of put it to the back of your mind and go on with it. But I think that it showed that it did affect us, and we can't afford to do that at this stage of the season, the way the games are going and the way we're sitting in the league. We have to just kind of pull the sleeves up and get on with it, because we know, obviously, if we play the way we can hurt teams in this league. But today, we can only apologise to the fans, because it was miles off it, and it's not acceptable.
And how do you go about, you mentioned there almost like a change in mindset between the two, how do you go about changing that? Is it just a case of application at training, or is it something else?
No, I think if you've seen the way the boys train all week, they've got the application there. It's just taking that from the kind of training ground into the game, because it's okay being a great footballer in training, but you need to turn up. They get paid to go out on a Saturday and show what they're made of then, and for the past couple of weeks we've not really shown that. So we have to just go in and work real hard this week. We always do work hard, but we need to then take it into the game next week against Morton, and we need to start picking up points and getting us further up the table.
We seem to struggle getting supply forward to you guys up in the final third, something that perhaps is going to have to be addressed soon.
Yeah, I think it's the way we started the game. We didn't start the game very well, and once a team gets a sensitive against you, then the defenders start dropping off, getting a bit worried, then the midfields drop off trying to create tighter gaps between them, but then that kills us further forward and there's two bigger gaps. I think we need to be a bit more braver, coming from the defence, and that comes from the goalkeeper as well, talking from the back. We need to squeeze the game and make the kind of the areas between the defence, midfield and the strikers that tighter, so we can get near players. I felt today we were just standing off and allowing them to kind of dictate the play, and then when they get the heads up and a bit of confidence, and then it's just a tough afternoon, and it's just a long afternoon, and we've done, obviously they had a lot more chances that they could have maybe put away, and we didn't create enough at the other end to obviously take something from the game. So it's a very, very difficult one to take. It's a disappointing afternoon, and we just need to kind of put that to bed. We can't do anything now, can't affect it. We need to just put our focus on Morton.
Yeah, I should say that Morton game coming up, there is still a long way this season to go, but we obviously can't wait too long before turning a corner, because we don't want a kind of gap to open up, do we?
Yeah, that's obviously a concern, but if the work that the gaffer's doing on a week-to-week basis, it's only a matter of time before it's going to turn. Obviously, we're looking at today's performance, that wasn't acceptable from the players' point of view, but the way the work that the gaffer does and stuff, and I know it's only going to be a matter of time, and we just need to be a bit more confident and braver to start games. And if we do go behind, we need to roll up the sleeves and get something from the game, instead of kind of sitting back and kind of being scared, low confidence, and we need to kind of just put all that out the back of our mind and just concentrate and going out and winning games.
And just finally, you mentioned that Morton game next week, it's back at the Falkirk Stadium, another tough game, but can we get something from that match?
Yeah, I think so. I think definitely we'll need to obviously analyse this game, see where we went wrong and things we can do, and then we'll study Morton and see where we can capitalise on them. And I'm fully confident that if we do everything right and we, as I say, get confidence and start the game well, then there's no reason why we can't go out there and get all 3 points next week.
Well, here's hoping we can. Thanks, as always, for your time.
All right. Thank you. Cheers. Thank you.